Hey everybody, welcome back to Tea Time. You smell that? Oh my god, it smells like Christmas in a cup. What is going on? I don't know. You go to the stores, normally I'm drinking like all kinds of herbal teas, but I drink a lot of green tea and whatnot, and now we have like a Christmas area. It's not even Labor Day. What is going on? I don't get it. Ooh, that's hot. Anyways, welcome back. Thank you for joining me. I really appreciate everyone that comes here and hangs out with me every week as we just talk about a whole bunch of nonsense, photography nonsense. Anyways, you see what I put here? The next big thing, guys. I mocked this up because I have absolutely nothing better to do with my life. That is a full frame inside an M50, or some people overseas call it an EOS KISS. That is what Canon will be coming up with very soon, very soon. We thought that we were going to see the camera right around Photokina, or at least an announcement, and then the camera right after. It seems to me that according to all the rumor sites, that we're going to hear an announcement on September 5th. Now, bear in mind, take all this with a grain of salt. Today, we're just going to be discussing the rumors and what has come in, what we think that's going to be in this camera, number one. And number two, what my thoughts are and our thoughts are about the mount. That's the most important thing in my personal opinion. So let's get into some of the specs and see where we go with it. But before I do, I want to say that we've been talking about Nikon, like I said, for like the last four or five videos, and I had to get away from it for a while. There's a lot of stuff going on right now. People are hating it. They're loving it. They're just fighting. And I am not about all that. I do not like to fight ever. I want to have a really good conversation and just talk to you guys about it and have this communication back and forth, an educated conversation. And I have to say, there is over, 1,200 comments on the last video, and it was really good. I think I had to delete like one or two because people started getting belligerent. You know how it goes. You always get those trolls, but that's not bad out of 1,000 or 1,200 or even more comments. So once again, I appreciate every one of you guys watching. Now, let me get into this whole Canon thing. I'm going to give you some specs. Once again, take them with a big handful of salt. And this is how they go. Either 24 to 28 megapixels is what they're saying. Dual pixel autofocus. IBIS. Have to have IBIS. 10 frames per second. That would be nice. Also, 4K at 30 FPS. Not really liking that. Would like to see 60. 1080p at 60 frames per second. That would be ridiculous. We need to have 120s, so we have slow-mo, and a price at $1,900. That kind of makes sense. Now, my question to you guys is, do you think that these specs will hold up? By me looking at them, I think that they will. I think the 10 frames makes sense. IBIS has to be in there. Dual pixel AF, they can't flub that up again. I mean, come on, Canon. Now, so let me just say one thing before I go any further. Some people will say that I'm a Sony fanboy, and then the next guy will say I'm a shill for Canon, and the next guy say that I... Trust me, guys, I am not. I really don't care what camera I use. I don't care. I don't have any loyalty for any manufacturer, and I'm just going to call it as I see it, and I hope you guys appreciate it. Now, let me say, Canon has been notorious over the last few years to just flub it up. Get right about there and just f it up. That's just what they do. Now, why do I say that? Well, you have like a 5D Mark IV, they screw up in the codec, then you have the M50, or now they call it the KISS, I guess, overseas, whatever you want to call it. They screwed up with that because they didn't put dual pixel AF on it if you're using 4K. So if you're using 1080p, then no problem. We'll give you dual pixel AF. If you're using 4K, sorry, we're going to shut off dual pixel AF. Just stupid stuff like that. They do it so they do not cannibalize, for example, their C series, which is their just mega successful video cameras, let's call them video DSLRs. I use them all the time, like a C300, whenever I do commercial video shoots. Why? Because they're just simply awesome. They never overheat. Why? Because they have a mega fan built into it that's blowing onto the sensor, right? They're just specifically made for video, and they do a really good job of it. And Canon is notorious for holding features back so that they don't cannibalize their other lines. I think this time, guys, in this big mirrorless wars that are going on, they're going to have a hard time holding back. Why do I say that? It's the same reason why I said Nikon kind of screwed up. Why? Because Sony has set a bar. Okay, if Canon and Nikon came into the mirrorless wars or the mirrorless market back 5.5 years ago when Sony did, well, then they could screw up and bring out a Gen 1. But at this point, Nikon and Canon have to bring a Gen 5 in. They cannot bring Gen 1 nothing. It just won't work. They cannot just wait 5 years to get it right. It's just not possible. Like I said, Sony set the bar, and now Canon and Nikon have to come up to the bar at least on par of the bar, on par of the bar, whatever it is, or above. Right? Or above. So I think that, like I said, Canon, where they normally drop the ball, they're going to have to at least be on par with an A7 Mark III or better. That's just simply it. That is the bottom line here. So my question is to you guys, do you think that these specs will hold water? Do you think that they won't? Do you think Canon will get it right? That's question number one. Number two, the mount. Now I talked to you guys about this, God, 5, 6, 8 videos ago. And my thought was, and my thought process was, how about if one of the major manufacturers, Nikon or Canon, keep their mount? Now, why is that? So you don't have to adapt glass and people can use all of their old glass onto these new mirrorless bodies that they come out with. That is great. Nikon found a solution, obviously, to their Z mount, right? It has an adapter. Fantastic. But Nikon was coming to the game with about a 44, 46 millimeter mount. A little bit small, right guys? A little bit small. Canon, on the other hand, has a 54 millimeter EF mount that they come up with 20 years ago or whatever. 54 millimeters, literally 1 millimeter smaller than the brand new Nikon Z mount. All right, so that to me means the mount could remain the same if they want. They have enough real estate there. It's big enough. It is big enough. Now, of course, we have to worry about flange distance and all this stuff, but they should be able to change the mount, call it whatever they want, all right, and still be able to receive or accept EF glass. That is my personal opinion. Can they do it? I really don't know. But if they did, it would be revolutionary, right? It would be revolutionary. No adapter needed. Now, some people have said that this is going to be called the EOS R and the mount is going to be like a REF or an EFR or whatever. I really don't care. Once again, this is all speculation. We're just having a conversation, just talking about what could be and where we think it's going to go. So, once again, I really don't care who wins these wars. It doesn't matter to me in the least. We're once again just having this conversation. I want to hear from you. What do you think about the mount? Number one. And do you think that Canon will just flub it up like they always have done in the past? Or do they have to get it right this time? Has Sony brought that bar to such a degree that they cannot not cannibalize their other DSLR units? They have to bring their game, their A game. Instead of always just slightly bunting the ball, they're going to have to go for the stands and hit that home run this time. I want to hear from you. What do you think? So guys, as always, if you enjoy my content, throw me a big thumbs up. That would be awesome. Smash the subscribe button so you get all my content when it becomes available and click the bell icon so when it is available, you will be notified of it. And finally, head over to my website, jchristina.com, where you can find all the photography tools that I've invented for you and me over the years. And hopefully there's something there you might like. And if there is, please pick it up and support me. That would be awesome. We'll see you in the next vlog. Thanks a lot, guys. Take care.